You know, life is a lot like shopping in a store. You accumulate things in your life. For some people, it's a house, it's a job, it's an education, a lot of things. You know, the unfortunate thing about life is that we don't just accumulate things, we also accumulate sin. In the book of Romans, it says that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We pick up a lot of different sins. Sins like jealousy, lust, envy. And we say to ourselves, you know what, what's the big deal? Everybody else is picking up the same stuff. Help me when you come. Well, after we finish our shopping, of course you take everything to the checkout. You know the drill, you put it on the counter, the cashier rings up everything, and you stand there and you wait to see what the price is going to be that you're going to have to pay. You know, the problem is that everything that we purchase can't be bought with money. See, in the beginning, in Genesis, God was telling Adam and Eve that they can have all of his creation except for one thing, and that was the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. But if they ate of it, that day they would surely die, is what Scripture says. So from the beginning, the penalty was death for our sin. It's not something that you can reach into your billfold to pay for. Have you ever gone up to the register and found out that you didn't have your billfold with you, or you didn't have your checkbook? You know, paying for sin is kind of like that. You come up short. You're unprepared for the penalty of sin. But unlike a grocery store, you can't necessarily go put stuff back on the shelf when you can't afford it. You can't turn around and say, I'll put this stuff away and come back later to pay for it. It doesn't work that way with sin. So what is it that we're supposed to do? Well, the Bible says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. He knew that you would owe for your sins. And when he came to earth, he came with the purpose of paying the price for your sin. So, as we think back on his crucifixion this Good Friday, as he hung there on the cross, his mission in mind to pay for your sin, to pay the price, to pay the cost, that's what was on his mind. And after he had finished that, was when he said, this is finished. It's done. This is what I came to do. I did it for you. It's finished.